Hey everybody, I'm the Linux Gamer. I've been waiting with bated breath for GDC 2015 and all the info that Valve were sure to drop. Now that it's come and gone, I wanted to make a news roundup video talking about what Valve and their hardware partners are planning for the end of the year. So here are all the cool things that Valve announced at this year's GDC. Valve partnered with hardware manufacturer HTC to create the Vive VR headset. By all accounts, the Vive headset blows every other VR experience out of the water. Not only does the Vive have crazy high resolutions, but it also allows players to stand up and walk around within a 15 square foot area and be fully tracked in game. The Vive also comes with two VR controllers that allow for precise spatial input. My chief concern about all this is how much it's going to cost. I'm not sure who will be able to afford it if it's too expensive. I've heard other people express concerns over the 15 square foot thing, as many people don't have enough room in their homes to set up something like that. It's a valid concern, and it's something Valve ought to address. Can you play with the Vive in an area smaller than 15 square feet? Can you be seated for the whole experience? We don't know yet. The full lineup of Steam machines has been announced, and there's a lot of variety. On the low end, we have systems like the Alienware Alpha, starting at a reasonable $479, while some of the other systems cost well over $4,000. To just about everyone, $4,000 is absurd. If I get a Steam machine, I'll go with something reasonably spec'd, but also something that leaves room for upgrades. However, the only clear advantage I see in buying a Steam machine is the form factor, and I think that needs to change. I believe Valve needs to address the critics who decry the Linux-based SteamOS and show the public exactly what they must have shown developers to convince them to port their games to the new platform. I believe that Valve should implement some kind of benchmarking system which makes comparing the varied hardware more meaningful. Specifically for people who will inevitably migrate from Xbox or PlayStation who don't know the difference between Nvidia and Radeon, let alone why a Core i5 would be better for gaming than a Pentium. Of all the Steam machines on offer, the one that appeals most to me in the cost versus hardware rubric is the Zotac Steam Machine SN970. I'm wondering what exactly Valve have planned, seeing as both the Zotac SN970 and the Alienware Alpha have HDMI inputs. What software will be included with these boxes that will utilize the HDMI input? Will we see a live TV tab in big picture mode? The Steam controller has finalized hardware, and I'm so excited. I love the direction the controller has taken, though I still wish it featured a touchscreen. I can't wait to get my hands on this. It looks like the perfect blend of comfort, convenience, and precision. I'll need to take it for a spin before I pass judgment, though. I'm somewhat of a gamepad nerd, so this radical new challenge to the tired, established controller is refreshing and exciting. Steam Link was also announced. Somewhat of a surprise to me, though a welcome one. It's essentially a streaming thin client designed for easy setup. For $50, I can't see any reason to not pick one up, especially considering the opportunity for tinkering with this thing. Details on this are light, but it seems like a promising little piece of tech. Valve have touted extremely low latencies streaming from in-home PCs, but I wouldn't be surprised if this is the Trojan horse of the Steam Machine lineup. Though it's not marketed as a Steam machine, being capable of 1080p decoding and 60 frames per second means it's gotta have some power behind it. Source 2 has officially been announced, and it's free for everyone, and that's spectacular news. In the game engine market, there are two major players vying for third-party dominance, Unreal and Unity. With Valve's latest entry into the engine space, their commitment to Linux and their undying support for the modding communities makes this good news for everybody. Vulkan was announced as a next-gen successor of sorts to OpenGL. Vulkan is a new graphics API that is largely based on AMD's now-defunct Mantle API. Many hardware vendors, including Nvidia and Intel, are showing off development drivers which support the new programming interface. So that was some of the biggest news for Linux gaming at GDC. And while some of it was only tangentially related to Linux, I'm thankful you're still watching. All in all, I'm excited for November, when most of this stuff is slated to be released. If you like this video, share it with your friends and be sure to click that like button. And remember to please subscribe to see more from me, the Linux Gamer. Thanks for watching.